And now, the story. The silence in the bedroom was deafening. The silence in bed, that was shattering. Normally, they play footsies, snuggles, and sometimes, depending on the universe, they do make love, but never this eerie tension. It's been a week since they last touched each other. You can literally hang a hat on the air. That's how tense it's grown. So, are we just going to lay in here, day in, day out, not talking every day for the rest of our lives? Well, I've got to tell you, I'm not. I'm asking you straight up, point blank, Miriam, what in the world have I done wrong? I can't believe you went off like that. And that's not all. You won't even talk about buying a replacement. And the boy has apologized several times. I knew it. I knew you were going to cave in. Let me tell you, I haven't felt any remorse from him. He's all, I've apologized. Now can I have my new halo back? I'm saying he's got to prove it. Prove it. I'm not falling. It's too easy. He walks you like potty, sweetheart. I'm sorry. He knows you love him too much. I mean, I love him too. He's my only boy, but he's got it wrong. This time he's got to learn. That night, there was no reply. There was improvement during the next couple of days. Being a weekend. On Saturday, they all woke up chipper-chipper and kind of got loose in the day-to-days, do these and do that. The next day, which is today, is Sunday. Memorial Day Sunday. And things were about to get better. Hey, Dad! Chase yells authoritatively. Huh? Oh, God. He squirms inside. How many times have I told him we don't say, hey, Dad, in Africa? That's so freaking rude. Oh, go, Fenwara. Yes, son. He answers as gently as he could. But then bounces right back to the point, as diplomatically as he could possibly muster up. Hear how I'm talking to you, son? No raised tone, no raised voice, no yelling. Try saying, hey, Dad, like that. Jay, Miriam interjected. No, Mom, I agree. Chase counter interjected. I agree with Dad. I can be more polite. There's such a thing as polite. I have been looking it up. It's not such a popular thing around America. He looks down, towel drying the dishes, but it is a cultural thing in Nigeria. That's what you told me, and I agree with it. The silence was again piercing the air. Jay, for no reason that he could readily explain, moved across the room to where Miriam sat. He asks, it's Sunday, baby. Aren't you going to miss Bob Hertz at Bishola? Miriam turns towards him, as if she was in the presence of a ghost. Obviously in disbelief that he's interested in her Sunday TV ritual. For some inexplicable reason, Jay turned on his loving self and charm. Ah, Ife Sokale. Love comes down. I see you, babe. I see that look in your eyes, like your eyes, our ears are playing tricks on you. No, they're not. You know, I probably never told you, but I do like Abishola. You know, she's from Nigeria, right? One heck of a talented young lady. Plays guitar, too. You know, hey, we've got to give it up for ourselves, for the motherland. Coming to America doesn't mean leaving Nigeria. For the first time in about 24, 48 hours, she cracked a smile. That smile, the one he fell in love with in the first place. Well, pass the remote then, she said, reaching out. He tossed it to her, and she catches it with precision. That's my Miriam. Catches like a fly. As he does, a quick tongue stick out, imitating a frog catching some fly. Her wrinkled forehead bore the fact that she didn't quite approve of that comparison, but she was ready to let it go. He didn't mean any harm. He wasn't being smart, stupid, maybe. Out of nowhere emerges Chase. Dad, Mom, can I join you guys for a minute? I've had nothing but good good stuff about that show. Jay looked at Miriam. They were just getting comfortable, for Christ's sakes. They rolled their eyes at each other and smiled. That's the end of touching. They shook their heads. Well, son, if I'm not imagining things, you asked me a question I haven't quite answered. Come on, Jay. Miriam does her loving mom thing as usual. Chase, who had slumped into the couch and grabbed some popcorn while at it, was either ignoring his dad or just in loving denial. As for Jay, his wrinkled forehead bore the fact that he didn't quite approve of this overlook, but he was ready to let it go. He didn't mean any harm. He wasn't being smart, stupid, maybe. Sunday night was good. I mean, really good. Even before retiring to bed, Jay had decided Chase was going to have his game back. He's a good kid. He just needs to know his boundaries and limitations. These millennials are different. I get it. But I'm not gonna throw away respect at the altar of millennial values.
I know what you're thinking.
Huh?
Why do you always have to wake up after I do?
He rolls his leg over her and loves on her again.
I had a talk with him. He got it. You've got to check your temper too, though, Jay. Besides the waste of money, explosions like that can get violent easily. Emotional explosions. By the way, you've got to realize that by the time you come round, it might be too late.
Yes, baby. I'm paying for it. I'm paying for it both ways. That's not only a punishment, it's a penance. Thought about it. I was really, really wrong.
Come here.
She chuckled.
There's more punishment for you yet.
They're loving queens, and whispers slowly merges with that of Chase in his room, whispering hard into his headset. Listen, you I'm not yelling and getting into trouble, losing my game again. But you tell me, where are you gonna go now? Where are you gonna run to now? Huh? It was a happy Sunday night all around. What's heavy? And now, The Voice. So, here we are again, at the altar of millennial values, to use Jay's words, in penance and in punishment. Punishment, as we can all see, has its benefits, exacting the fact that joy and pain, loss and gain, can be mutually possessive. But that's a philosophy for somewhere down the line. As far as this loving, long weekend is concerned, it's been love fest in the Jay family. Believe me when I say it wasn't exactly the easiest puzzle to put together. The days were like decades, and the feeling was toxic. What Jay did, thank goodness to his loving spouse, was listen. He lowered the banner of anger and arrogance. He had, later on that night, sincerely confessed to Miriam that he was burning up inside, that it appeared that he was at cross purposes with himself. He confessed to realizing that even though Chase was being punished, he as dad was being punished too. Punishment and penance take on a whole new meaning in this episode. His sin was his karma. For opening up the floodgates of anger, he isolated his wife, his family, and himself. Only he knew the hellish pain he endured, the killing silence, and the mind-altering environment. The atonement was his realization. The correction was also his good karma. He fixed it. What was seemingly broken is now fixed. Such is the power of self-analysis and correction. Self-analysis and correction. There's a school I belong to where it's called Human Revolution. And guess what? It can actually be contagious. Like a good virus that can erode the impurities of body and mind, it is said to be able to turn poison into medicine. If you observe, the self-examination happened across the board in the family. Jay had a rethink on his anger issue. Miriam learns to give and take with Jay so life can have meaning. And Chase, he simply listened as well, matured up like they'll say around these parts, and kept it down, literally, really down. Really, an extension of the neutral ground we discussed last episode, right? Everyone gave a part of themselves and got something bigger and better back. Isn't that something? Yes, my school of thought calls it human revolution. And it is believed that the human revolution in one individual can go on to affect the life of one, two, three, just as exemplified in our family, and it can go on to effect and affect a good invaluable change in society and country, in the world and the universe, all with time. That's how strong the wave could be. Food for serious thought. And with that, we come to the end of the first in our series, A Story of Voice, two-part episode, of course with many more stories to come. In the meantime, from our spoken word corner this week comes the white wanderer from a body of mine, Sadez Larido. It's an honor to speak your words. As constant as the rooster's crow in the morning, the old geezer pounds the streets every evening, dressed like the cattle egret in spotless white, his shirt, trousers, and shoes always white, his crown a haloed white, a fitting tribute to his gleaming white teeth and a big contrast to his ebony face. As striking as his appearance are his manners, he is the gentle evening breeze that caresses your tired limbs and stifles a languid yawn. He yawns in greeting if you meet his gaze and speaks in a peculiar diction that betrays his many travels. When Mama answered the home call, the man in white had come home to pay his respects, and thus began his street pounding every evening. As constant as the rooster's crow in the morning, dressed like the cattle egret in spotless white, his crown a haloed white, a fitting tribute to his gleaming white teeth.
What's heavy behind?
I can hear you asking already, what's he dishing us this week anyway? Musically, that is. Well, as you know, there's a limitation to music usage, except it's royalty-free when you're podcasted. So I searched and researched. I was looking for something encouraging, something motivating, something that's moving on-ish, something to the tune of letting bygones be bygones. I finally found one that I felt. So, our Alex Growl with a funky riff from the latest episode morphed into our sick tune, and this discovery of mine, simply called Heavy by a group called Birdwalker, walked on me. I trust you're feeling them too. That's what you've been listening to. Simply follow the lyrics if you care. Listen to the story and hear the voice. Only makes sense to keep it in the ballpark. I'm remembering the James Robertson gang this week from way back. Aye Kwanko, Yemi Gbenro, Fashintin Dagbasioke, Dakwa Fashanu, Baba Rosa, Tude Babarinsa, Jimmy D, Jimmy Disu, Lanre Dowu, Scooby Doo, Shewun Shonoiki, Taiwo Obe, and all the other boys I'm confident will forgive me for not doing a personal mention. You guys are my peeps of the week.
I want to bleed your blood and I want to be let in. Don't you just, don't we all just want to be.
This has been a happy week in our family story. Let's make it real in our life stories too. Seek happiness. Don't block the emotions. Happy or sad, own them, embrace them. This is Jimmy Banks. It's been nothing but a delight to be here again. If you promise to be here in another fortnight, I'll be here too. Then we can both take a look in the mind of a man. Durango is worth every word. Until then, as they say in one of the several tribes I love, Tojuiwe, keep your character.